My mom fought for equal rights, for women's access to quality health care. She fought against racism, against bigotry, against intolerance. These were the defining moments of my youth. But the defining moment for me and my passion for justice came when I was 20 years old. I was a student at UW-Madison, and I went down with a group of friends to see a Talking Heads concert, and my friend who I was walking with saw that every car on the street had a ticket and thought that was kind of funny, picked up the ticket, and before he could put it back on the car, a police officer came over and arrested him. And I went down to the station on my own, walked in, and assuming that I would be able to get him out. And the police officer came out and called over a female officer and said, "Take her back, strip search her." And I had taken a constitutional law class at Madison. I knew that was wrong. I said to him, "You can't do that. I'm not under arrest." And he came this close to me and he said, "Well, then I'll arrest you. What do you want? What do you want? What do you want?" So I went, but I knew that it was wrong, and I decided to pursue that. It turned out that Chicago TV station had a short little excerpt on how this was happening in Chicago routinely to women, only women, for things like girls being in the high school hall without a pass, women who had taken wrong turns and were taken down to the station and strip searched. And the ACLU immediately said they were going to start a lawsuit. And they said their phone rang for days. Well, I was one of the people who called them. And I ended up being Jane Doe number one in that lawsuit. They liked my case because I was never arrested. I was never suspected of a crime. I was a woman who was strip searched, and my friend, who was a man, was never strip searched, even though he had been arrested. Well, it hit the radar screen, and for those who remember, Phil Donahue used to be in Chicago at that time. He immediately had a show. I went down. I was on the Donahue show. I was on the show with a number of women, a sit-down striker, a teacher here from Wisconsin, and two nuns who ran a homeless shelter, and the police had gone and rounded everyone up and taken them from station to station to station and strip searched them at every single station all night long. The nuns. And so, needless to say, things changed fast. The Chicago police changed it. But they fought it all the way up through the court system and had to have the courts tell them this was unconstitutional. Illinois changed its statute on this. Even Wisconsin addressed the issue. And over the years, I saw that in places like Houston and New York and a lot of other places addressed this. The American Civil Liberties Union estimated that in Chicago alone, 10,000 women had been subjected to the strip search. So what it showed me as a college student was how incredibly important it is that we have our courts there to protect us when branches of government abuse their power. It was the impetus for me to go to law school. It's been the impetus